Emmerdale spoilers, Kim Tate pushed by this person? Did you spot the major clue? Emmerdale made its climax this evening, when scenes from the storyline of Kim Tate being pushed from a balcony aired. But who was responsible for the push? And do these clues reveal the culprit? Emmerdale viewers tuned into a dramatic first episode of the soap tonight, which saw Kim Tate, played by Claire King, fall from a balcony, crashing to the floor moments later. But did she fall or was she pushed? And who is responsible? Following her conversation with Sam Dingle, James Houghton, earlier in the episode, it is highly likely Faith Dingle, Sally Dexter, is to blame. She, Kim, is one nasty piece of work, Faith began. She's poison, that's what she is, and she's hurting our family. When Sam questioned Faith about what she was going to do about the situation, she remarked, "Something, at least. Not just roll over and take it, bite back." Faith was then seen leaving the room to go and get some air, only to return back to the party after Kim had fallen. Scenes showed Kim lying cold on the floor, blood rushing from her head, whilst the village residents surrounded her in panic. Moments later, Faith came out of a side door and walked straight into the drama. Curious as to her whereabouts, her partner Eric commented, "Faith, where have you been? Kim ordered us to leave." "Oh, what the heck?" "Someone wasn't very happy about it by the looks of it," she exclaimed. "Stop gawping at me like that. I was joking, obviously," Faith explained, looking away very suspiciously. Could Faith have followed Kim upstairs and pushed her off the balcony? It comes after her granddaughter Debbie Dingle, Charlie Webb, was meant to marry Jodate, Ned Porteous, in the hospital chapel earlier that evening. But following Kim's order for Graham Foster, Andrew Scarborough, to get rid of Joe permanently, Debbie was left jilted at the altar. Whilst Joe ran away with £100,000, with the promise never to return to the Dales again. However, unable to stay away from Debbie, Joe returned to Home Farm, but was stopped from entering by Kane Dingle, Jeff Hordley, and Graham. In a surprising turn of events, Kane punched Joe square in the face, knocking him back, causing him to hit his head on a rock before falling onto the ground. Whilst Graham insisted Joe had been killed by the punch, is he really dead? And who will get the blame?